dolls, I'm Babs, and today we're going to answer your questions that you left for me in the comments section. So for everyone who is new, again, my name is Babs. I am an OBGYN sonographer. I have over 6 years experience. And honestly, that's not really much. There's still a lot that I do not know. And every day is an opportunity for me to learn something new. I'm also not a doctor, so my knowledge is mostly just ultrasound based and what I hear the doctors around me tell their patients. So I thought I've received enough questions from you guys to finally film a Q&A. Oddly enough, those are only GYN questions. Either the pregnant ladies are not finding my videos or they're getting their answers from somewhere else. But that's not too surprising considering my most popular video is what to expect during your pelvic ultrasound. Let's start with the first question by Orange. Can the abdominal ultrasound reveal virginity? The simple answer is no. Not even a transvaginal ultrasound can reveal virginity. Since we're on the topic of virginity, I'm just gonna dive into this topic a little bit more. First, for anyone who does not know this, a virgin can still get a transvaginal exam. Also, whether you're a virgin or not, you do not have to have the transvaginal portion if you do not want to. No one will force you. If you are a virgin and a minor, we do not do the transvaginal parts. Although I have done it once on a minor, but that was a special case. She was a teenager, I think around 16. Her mother was there. They had to fill out a form because as a minor, the transvaginal portion became like a special procedure. And the attending doctor was there. He didn't perform it, I performed it, but he was there explaining what was going on, what they were looking at, etc., etc. If you are a virgin and well into your adulthood, like anywhere like 30s, 40s, 50s, or if you haven't been sexually active in a very, very, very long time, you can still say no. Anyone can say no, but checking just on top may or may not give the best views of your pelvic organs. Now, I used to get annoyed when a patient would come and tell me that she doesn't want to do the second part at all. And it's not because she was a virgin or anything like that. She just doesn't want to do it. But now I don't really care because at the end of the day, I still get paid. And if the doctor doesn't get the answers that they need from just checking on top transabdominally, then that's on the patient. But everyone who has said no as an adult has their reasons. I never asked because I don't care. Their reasons could be they're on their period, even though we could still do it on your period. Maybe they weren't fresh, maybe they didn't shave. Again, we could still do it. It doesn't matter to us. Maybe they had a bad experience in the past, or maybe they're super dry and or super tight and it would be very uncomfortable for them. But it's none of my business. I don't ask. They just want to check on top. We just check on top. But I always tell them that first they need a very full bladder. And even with a very full bladder, we still may not get what we need. Checking just on top, just transabdominally, may not show us what we need very clearly, even with a full bladder. Which leads to the next question. Megan H. asks, can you test for PCOS without a transvaginal ultrasound? And can you see cysts with a transabdominal ultrasound and not a transvaginal ultrasound? So before I dive further into that question, let's define PCOS. Now, PCOS is polycystic ovarian syndrome, and the Mayo Clinic defines that as a hormonal disorder common among women of reproductive age. Women with PCOS may have infrequent or prolonged menstrual periods or excess male hormone levels. The ovaries may develop numerous small collections of fluid follicles and fail to regularly release eggs. Now, PCOS is not strictly diagnosed through ultrasound. An ultrasound is only one piece of the puzzle. Your doctor will need to do a physical exam and take hormone tests. Now, right before ovulation, one or two ovaries will start developing cysts, follicular cysts, and then one of them will get really, really big and burst out an egg, right? That's how it goes. With polycystic ovaries, they're a little bit more distinct. Their look is different than just regular follicular cysts. I will insert pictures somewhere so you could see. Okay, so can you see polycystic ovaries only from on top? Again, only if it's super, 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 super clear. Yes, you could see cysts from on top. But if we do see cysts, sometimes a transvaginal portion is required to distinguish them between polycystic ovaries and regular follicular cysts. Next question. Sarah Ducky Willett asks, does the hymen break during the process and does it hurt? Now, I've already answered these questions individually in the comment section of the video, so I wanted to make this video in case any one of you out there hasn't seen that video and didn't see those questions asked in the comment section can know the answer. So this hymen question I already answered, but I answered it, I believe, without knowing exactly what the hymen was. Now, everyone has heard of the hymen, and we all heard stories, or we've all been told, that this is kind of like an indicator of virginity. You know, when you have sex, it breaks. When you ride a horse, it breaks. When you do the split, it breaks. You know, whatever. But I can't recall if I actually did some research before I answered her. I want to say that I did, but I can't remember. But I definitely did right now. So let's dive into what the hymen actually is. So the hymen is a thin membrane that surrounds the opening of the vagina. The hymen comes in different shapes. The most common hymen shape is shaped like a half moon. This shape allows menstrual blood to flow out of the vagina. Okay, so that totally makes sense, because how would you have your period how would you have your period if the hymen completely closes the opening of the vagina? That wouldn't make sense. That would cause a problem, which will cause you to see the doctor, and then, you know, it would be diagnosed very early. And that also makes sense because some girls start using tampons at a very early age. So the hymen has an opening and it stretches. So it accommodates whatever is inserted. So it doesn't really break. You'd have to have a serious injury for it to break. So I'm gonna say that no, just like I answered that question originally, no, the probe does not break the hymen. And does it hurt? That's different. Most people tolerate it pretty well with only feeling pressure. So some people who feel pain are those who are already having pain. That's why they're getting an ultrasound, because they're having pain down there and we're trying to figure out what's going on. Other ladies who might feel pain are ones who are probably old, like very old, or they're very dry and they're very tight. Those are the ones who are probably not sexually active at all, because it is extremely painful to do so. Now, the probe should be inserted slowly and gently with enough lubricant to make it comfortable for you, or as comfortable as possible. So don't worry, ladies, with me, virgin or not, young or old, I'll take care of you. And to the viewer who commented saying that she was having an ultrasound exam, a pelvic ultrasound exam, and that she was freaking out, I hope it all turned out well. I hope the ultrasound was useful. and I hope it wasn't too traumatic for you. I have some other videos for you to watch next. I'm sure you will thoroughly enjoy them. If you're pregnant, that is, or if you're planning on being pregnant, because these videos are OB videos, if you have any questions on GYN ultrasound, please leave them in the comment down below, and I'll see you next time. Ciao!